We'll try to keep you entertained, right? So just before starting the session, right, it's sort of a survey kind of thing. Like, how many of you like have been contributing, right? Contributing, like, it does not mean just code, right? Anything can be a contribution in case we talk about open source. Okay, a couple of us, even Enzo does a lot of contribution probably. So let's start off. So this particular session is about a story about our organization, right? So I'm Ashish and I basically work as a team lead for Cerigen. So we are a company based out of India, and so in case we talk about, right, so our basically contributions were always a part of our culture, right? But what has been done, like after multiple iterations and after multiple steps, and in fact, like after multiple failures, right, it has been in the past 1.5 years that we have been able to sort of maintain a good and a healthy contribution culture in our organization, right? So what we wanted to do, right, is like in this particular session, share our story, right? What exactly we did to basically maintain and encourage a sort of a healthy contribution within our organization, and why we felt that thing was important to us, right? So there would be a two factor, a how and why, right? And apart from that, right, since I believe like a couple of people in the audience are also contributing, so we would also love to hear back from them as well, right? So rather than keeping this as a one-way session, a sort of a feedback and a sort of a consistent feedback and a sort of a questionnaire kind of thing within the session itself would be good, so that like we can also learn from them, and maybe using their feedback, probably we can try to incorporate those changes within our organization and try to develop a much more healthier conversation, a sort of a healthier contribution culture within our organization. What do you, Manjeet?
Thanks, Ashish. So hello, everyone. My name is Manjeet, and I'm a front-end developer at Cerigen Technologies. So if I talk about my contribution, so I have start my contribution with a documentation. So at that time, I don't know how to contribute to core issues and how to create a patch. So in 2013, I have attended Drupal Camp Delhi, and so there are very good mentors who helped me and encouraged me to contribute into a Drupal core, and he helped me to how to create a patch. So it is because of that mentorship, so I have jumped into the list of the contributors. So in our session, we will explain how we will fetch the other people's decision for contributions. So that's it.
Yeah. So since I was the person like leading this contribution contribution initiative in our organization, but Ravin, basically Manjeet and a couple of guys were the ones who were basically doing the things on the ground, right? So he has a more perspective, like what exactly was done on the ground to basically organizing sprints and all the stuff, right? So let's go into our next slide. So in case we think about any open source technology, right? Personally, I feel any open source technology is quite similar to environment, right? So much of the things which we consume, right, comes directly or indirectly from environment, right? Although like for some of the things we have to pay some sort of cost, but things like air, right, that is sort of free of cost, like we breathe fresh air from the environment, right? So I believe as we human beings, we form a community, right? And it is sort of a moral obligation of each and every human being to sort of contribute to environment, right? And contribution can be anything, right? For basically saving environment or contributing back to environment, you don't have to be a Superman, right? Anything can count, right? Probably saving light, saving energy, right? Saving water, even that is a small contribution, right? Similarly, in case we talk about open source, right? Open source, and in case we talk about open and free source, free and open source software, right? In this particular, in open source, basically, the entire technology stack is available to you as a free of cost, right? So as an organization or as a company, we can provide sort of services using that open source, or maybe we can develop our product using that open source, right? So in case we think about, it is a sort of a obligation, or maybe a sort of a, quite similar to environment, right? It is sort of a moral obligation as an individual, as well as an organization, to give back to the open source, right? Because in case we talk about a sort of a sustained environment or a sustained, in case we talk about the sustainability of the place where we live, right, a sort of initiative has to be taken by the people who are living here, right? Similarly, a sustainability of any open source also depends on the contribution of an organization as well as an individual. So in next couple of slides, what we will do, we'll cover like how and why exactly should an individual contribute back to environment, not to environment, sorry, like since like it's kind of sort of analogy, right? So I might keep on saying environment to open source. And after that, we'll cover a story from an organization perspective of like what exactly, what we did at Cirigent to contribute back to open source, right? So in our case, like the open source technology initially was just Drupal, right? But this particular session could be used as an example for any other open source technology, right? Probably you are working with Node.js, you are working with Angular, probably MySQL, right? This thing can be basically taken as an example for any other technology, right? So why should an individual contribute to an open source, right? Firstly, better software, right? So quite unlike any proprietary or a paid software, right? It is the community that basically drives the software quality of any open source project, right? So in case we come forward and try to contribute back to the software, right? In case we try to, let's say, in case documentation does not exist for a particular part of the software, or let's say there is some sort of issue which you find while working on any open source software, right? You can probably file a bug, and in case you are technically efficient or like capable enough to fix that bug and contribute back to the open source technology, right? So that is basically a contribution as an individual, right? So what this thing would lead to? This thing would eventually lead to a better software which everyone can use, right? Eventually, so not just you, there might be some other guys basically who are also contributing back to the open source, right? So eventually the entire set of contribution by the entire community would lead to a software which is like better to use, and in fact you can also say like one of the best open source technologies, right? And in case we talk about some other reasons why exactly one should contribute, so any open source technology, right, it is not just about the code, right? The community also forms one of the integral part of any open source technology, right? So to be really glad, right, so Drupal is one of the technologies wherein like both code as well as the community, which is like really vibrant, right? It was because of the Drupal community I stayed back and started full-fledged using Drupal, right? I was more of a C guy before. So while I jumped into Drupal, in case I talk about my story, right? I jumped into Drupal in 2012. And there were a couple of mentors from Australia who had basically mentored me to how exactly to write a Drupal code, right? So because of their mentorship and because of the community, I always felt what exactly an open source community means, right? So as an individual, as what we have to do, basically we have to grow the community as well, right? So growing the community means like this particular event would lead to the growth of the community, right? Probably there might be a couple of the guys in the audience like who might not be familiar with Drupal, right? So this particular event or maybe a smaller event or smaller promotion leads to the growth of the community, right? So in case the community is big, that would eventually lead to nothing but a better software, right? So a vibrant community and a good community eventually leads to a better software. Helps enhancing skill sets, right? So how exactly your skill set can be enhanced, right? So let's assume you work for a company and the developers, and let's assume the technical folks within your company is around, I'm not assuming the big companies, right? Let's say large to mid-scale companies, right? Mid-scale companies, let's assume you have around 100 developers within your company, right? And in case you get stuck with any problem, probably you can go ahead and discuss that problem with your colleague, right? But assuming you are working on any open source, right? Rather than just reaching out to your colleagues, you can also reach out within the forums, right? And basically you can discuss your problem with a wider audience. So what happens? This eventually leads to enhancing your skill sets, right? Because every good open source project would have a really vibrant community wherein you would have mentors and peers to help you out within in the forums. There could be IRCs and all the stuff, right? There could be issue queues, and they would make sure to help you out, right? They won't give you the direct answer, but they would basically give you hints and solution through which probably you can then use a bit of your brain and then come out with a solution, right? That would eventually lead to enhancing your skill set, right? And skill set does not mean just the technical skill set, right? So what happens, like some of the people might not be good at like probably written communication or verbal communication, right? So in case you want to reach someone in the community, right? Probably you have to use some sort of language which is the sort of a de facto in the community, right? Probably that is English in our case, right? So eventually what would happen, you would basically reach out to your mentor, right? You would eventually, that would eventually lead to a better communication skills, right? Even that, I mean, sort of a written communication. In case you go ahead and sort of present in such kind of cons, right? That would also lead to a better verbal communication skills, right? So contributing back to open source also helps enhancing your skill sets. Friendship and bonding, right? So it is through such events, right, like Drupal cons and Drupal camps and all the stuff, or probably some other cons or events of some other technology, right? We get to meet someone whom we always talk on forums or maybe on IRC, right? I knew who exactly XGM was, right? I knew who exactly Dries was, right? Like Webcheek I knew through Inzo as well, right? We knew him from like IRCs and all the places, right? But probably we never met in person, right? So it is through such events, right? It is through community, like we get a sort of a develop a sort of a online bonding with them, and it is through such events in case we meet those people in person, right? It gives a really good feeling, right? So an open source technology contribution would also lead to friendship and bonding, right? Finally, networking, right? In case we talk not in terms of friendship and bonding, it also leads to a sort of a networking. And by networking, I mean sort of a business kind of networking, right? In case you try to contribute back to the open source technology quite frequently, you develop a really good reputation within the community, right? So that would eventually lead to some sort of business referrals. Let's say you are a freelancer, not taking example of organization, right? Rather in case of freelancers or guys or sort of a consultant people, right? In case you contribute back frequently, right? That leads to a good reputation, and there might be some senior guy or some other folk in the community, he can refer you, right? I have a project, like since you've been contributing pretty actively in the community, right? Why don't you like do this project for me, right? So in case we talk about the founders of the Basecamp, right? So one of the co-founders of the Basecamp, like Basecamp is what was made in Rails, right? So one of the co-founders of the Basecamp reached out to some other guy who was like actively basically participating in the Rails community, and he turned out basically he was just one of another co-founder while they formed Basecamp, right? So this eventually leads to a better networking. Any questions still far? How, right? So we talk about from an individual perspective, right? How exactly can I contribute, right? So this can be sort of intimidating, right? I want to give back, but I'm not sure how, right? So that is really important, right? So in case we talk about any contributions, there is a sort of a misconceived perception that contribution is only a technical contribution, right? That is not the case, right? So in case, let's say you are an individual using any open source technology, in case you don't have much time or let's say technical capabilities, right? You can contribute back financially, right? So you like there's an option for becoming an individual member of Drupal.org, right? Similarly, like we consume a lot of our knowledge like comes from Wikipedia, right? And every year, like there is a sort of a campaign by Wikipedia founder, right, by Jimmy Wales. Like, would you like consider giving $5 or $10 to Wikimedia Foundation, right? So in case you don't have time or bandwidth to contribute in any other way, right? Probably a financial contribution would be much more easier for many of the folks, right? Still not technical, right? In case you want to still give back to any open source, right? You can volunteer and try to organize such kind of events, right? Let's say there's an event coming in your town, right? That is an open source event, right? You can say like, I want to basically volunteer for this event, right? That is also a contribution, right? So in case you are quite familiar with an open source technology, you can go ahead and try to set up some sort of meetings and events and try to add those in meetups, right? So that is a contribution, right? Every small bit counts, right? As I talked about in case of environment, every small bit counts, right? Saving lives counts, right? Saving water counts, right? So every small bit counts, right? So even this is a contribution. Translations, right? So translation is a sort of a really cool part, right? So, any questions? No, yeah, I can go ahead, sorry. So translation, in case we talk about many of the software, particularly Drupal, right? Drupal is more of a multilingual software, right? We can basically build a site in English, we can build a site in Arabic, probably Chinese, Japanese, right? But some of the text which we see, right, that is not easily available, initially just available in English, right? Probably the contributors have to translate that particular thing to your native language, right? So translation is something which you can contribute. Still, it is not technical, right? All you have to do, let's say there's something called, let's take an example, right? There's some particular text which shows up in English, right? You can translate that particular thing in your language, and that would be a small contribution as a translation to that particular software, right? Documentation, right? Still not technical in case we talk about, right? In case you are really good at a particular part of a software or a part of any open source software, right? And you feel a documentation is missing for that particular part, right? You can go ahead and write a documentation for that particular part so that using your documentation, the rest of the people who are using that software, it could be beneficial for them, right? So this is also a contribution. Helping in forum and IRC, right? Helping in forum and IRC, like since you went ahead and sort of seeked feedback in the forums and IRC, so it would be really great. You could also go ahead and help in forum as IRC, right? This might need a bit of technical capability, right? Let's say you get stuck in some sort of PHP problem or some sort of Drupal problem, right? So you can reach out to people in forums in IRC and they can probably give you a solution, right? That might be a technical solution. For this, you might need a bit of a technical capabilities, right? And last, not the last, in case you are a business guy, right? Let's say you have basically made a really cool site on Drupal, right? And you can go ahead and publish a case study on Drupal.org, right? So this is a site which we made, and these are the features, these are the modules which we use, right? So for basically project manager and the business guys, right? A case study would be really good contribution in case we talk about Drupal, right? I believe like rest of the open source technologies do have a page to publish case studies, right? So you can go ahead and publish a case study for your project in case your client allows, right? There might be sort of an NDA like wherein like you are not allowed to publish some sort of case studies openly. But in case it is allowed, I would suggest, especially for the business guys or the sales guys or the project manager, right, to go ahead and publish case studies for the project. And this is the last part, right? So in case we check all the above points, right, financial contribution, organizing events and volunteering, translations, documentation, helping in forum and IRCs, case studies, right? Leaving the documentation part and the forum and IRC part, much of the things were non-technical, right? So in case you are a technical guy and a hardcore techie, right, you can publish modules, you can publish themes, you can write patches, right? So themes, module, and patches might be a similar thing which could be used in other technology, right? But themes and modules, like it is so most, like this particular, these two words are more of mostly like used in the Drupal world, right? In case you are working in, let's say Node.js, right? Node.js might have something, probably some plugin kind of thing, right? You can probably publish that particular plugin as a contribution to Node.js community, right? So that a particular functionality which you have built might be used someone else who is also using Node.js, right? So these are only modules, themes, and patches, and forum, helping in forums and IRC, right? These are the only technical contribution in case we check this entire list, right? So in case we talk about now sustainability, right? Let's assume I'm the only guy who is trying to contribute, right? That is not sustainable, right? So individual contributions are always great, right? But in case I'm contributing alone, I can say like, why don't I reach out to Manjit and ask him like, why don't you come ahead and try to contribute, right? I'm doing nothing but sort of I'm encouraging him to contribute back, also promoting the technology, right? So sustainability would only come in case the community would become big, right? So, and the entire set of the community is trying to give back to the community, to the technology, right? So I believe it is a sort of a collective responsibility of the entire community, right, to give back, right? So only after a collective contribution would eventually lead to a sustainability, right? Because a single guy doing like he's not a Superman, right? That is not sustainable. So it is a sort of a community effort which can basically sustain any open source project, right? That is one of the reasons like it has been around 15 years and Drupal is still running and we are doing pretty well, right? Now we would talk about from an organization perspective, right? This is a story about my company, right? I basically work for Cerigen, right? And this is a story which in next couple of styles, basically we will check the same things, but how and why from an organization perspective. Why exactly should an organization contribute, and how exactly should an organization contribute, right? And this would be a sort of a candid and an honest feedback, like the things which we did good, like things we screwed up badly, and the sort of challenges which we have been facing in past couple of years to basically maintain a sort of a consistency, right? Even though we have done pretty well, but there is a sort of a lacking, but there are a lot of challenges which we are still facing, and probably someone in the audience can, in case you want to share your perspective on that, probably we can learn from them and probably try to implement, re-implement those things in our organization, right? So in case we talk about from an organization perspective, right, why should an organization contribute, right? Let's say I work for Cerigen and we do not contribute, right? We are just consuming Drupal, right? Just consuming and delivering the projects to our clients and not contributing back, right? So this means like we are sort of a consumer, right, and not contributing back, right? In case we are contributing back to the to Drupal or any other open source technology, right, it shows our commitment towards the open source technology, right? So contribution, so this helps ensure the future of Drupal project, right? So individuals can contribute through financially, codes, patches, IRCs, forums, and all of the stuff, right? But in case an entire organization basically encourages their entire basically developers and themers or probably QAs as well, as in fact the business guys as well, to contribute back, right? That would eventually lead to a better future of Drupal, right? So and basically a contribution from an organization perspective is really important from a basically for the better future of Drupal project, right? Because for such events, for the events like DrupalCon and other bigger events, right? Because these such kind of events need funding, right? And an individual cannot basically afford to give such kind of big funding to organize such kind of events, right? So it is here the organization would come in, right? So as an organization, I would encourage you, in case you are working for a company, right? In case you're not able to basically submit in, basically contribute back in terms of technical stuff, right? I would always encourage you to basically go ahead and do some sort of financial contribution to the organization, right? Not organization, sorry, open source project.
But how do you encourage your employees to contribute back to the community?
Yeah.
How do you encourage?
Yeah, that's what we'll cover in the next slide, right? What we did, right? Right. So this eventually leads to development and learning, right? So this thing I had also covered while I was discussing basically contributions from an individual perspective, right? So in case you want to enhance the skill set of your employees, right? Probably you might arrange trainings, right? But there might be a case, the trainer might be available in-house, right? But there might be a possibility the trainer might not be available in-house, right? In case your entire set of people who are working for you, right, they go ahead and try to contribute back, right? That would eventually lead to their development, right? So basically, in case this you try to maintain a consistency, right, I believe a training is not required, right? That's what really helped us, right? Sales, right? So in case an organization is really committed towards any open source project, right, and in case you have a really good sales team who is capable of showing your commitment towards the organization, right? And you need a really good marketing team, you need a really good sales team, so that they are able to show like and present a use case like we have been doing a really good stuff in the community basically trying to give back to the community. And for some of the cases, this might also help you for a better sales pitches, right? How? So in this particular slide, we would cover like from an organization perspective, what exactly should an organization do to promote a healthy contribution culture within their organization. This is more of our story, right? So in case we talk about full-time core contributors or multiple core contributors, right? So just a small question here. So in any of the companies which you work for, like, do you have a full-time core contributor? Right. So to talk about a bit of history of this, right? It was in May 2014, right, to be precise. Dries wrote a blog about like having a full-time core contributor, right? By core contributor means like the guy would basically sit and And he would not work on any project, right? Not work on any client project or some other in-house project. Rather, that particular guy would be resourced fully to contribute back to Drupal project, right? Basically, that time Drupal was, in case we talk about it, it was basically meant for a faster release of Drupal 8, right? So many companies like Acquia and a couple of companies in India as well came forward and basically resourced a full-time core contributor, right? So in case we talk about our story, right, we also sort of like, our CEO came back from DrupalCamp, and he was DrupalCon rather, right? And he was really excited, right? We have something like this, right? So at that time, like, I was one of the guy who was basically contributing quite frequently, right? So it was sort of decided that I would be one who would be serving and representing Srijan for this role, right? But apparently what happened, I was a part of a project, and that project came to us for a specific reason. The previous vendor was basically changing the team too frequently, right? So I could not basically jump into that role immediately, like we basically came to this decision, right? Rather, a sort of a phase was decided, like within 3 months, I would finish this project. Then after 3 months, I would shift as a full-time core contributor, right? But in case we tried to post, and apparently we didn't have any other person to serve this role as well at that time. So in case we try to postpone things to future, right, sometimes what happens, like, it never happens, right? That thing also happened with us. It never happened for us, right? Because after that 3 months, a really big account came to us, and due to some sort of resourcing problems, right, I could not go into this role, right? I had to rather shift to that project, right? But during that 3 months wherein, like, I had to finish a project, what I realized, like, rather than me just contributing back, right, it would be really good. I can sort of try to onboard the entire set of organization and sort of encourage everybody to contribute back, right? So what would happen is, like, it is a dependency for contribution is not just limited to a single guy. It is rather the entire set of people who is contributing back to Drupal project, right? So Manjeet was the guy. Basically, I was basically leading this entire effort, but on grounds, I was basically present for a single time just to organize a first sprint. And Manjeet and a couple of guys in Delhi office, our Delhi office, were the people who did it on site, right? They were the real guys who did the stuff, right? I was the guys who were just writing the mails. So Manjeet would take up on next couple of points.
Yes. So as Ashish had already mentioned, that this is some sort of a story with a Srijan. So initially, at the first time, we had organized a sprint, and there was a one mentor that who will mentor the other peoples. But at that time, only developers know how to contribute into the core issue. But QA and other Drupal themers don't know how to resolve core issues and how to create a patch. So we had organized the first sprint, and there was only one mentor. So in the feedback, people are saying that, I don't know. So mainly questions are from QA and Drupal themers. So they are saying that, we don't know how to resolve the core issues and how to create a patch. So that is a positive feedback. So we had increased the number. So in next sprint, we had increased the mentors. So there are 4 to 5 people. So they had mentor the other people. So basically, mainly to themers and QA to how to resolve issues. Some sort of example. So one mentor to the mentoring to other Drupal themers. So he will explain how to find issues from the Drupal queue and how to resolve that issues. So Drupal themer resolve that issue and go to the QA guys. So they can test that issues and move to the review and tested by community. So personally, I felt that that is only benefit for me. But if I can fetch the other people from organization, so that would be benefit from those guys as well. So that was a good initiative from. That was a good initiative from us. And so we had organized other sprints. So we are organized on a Friday nights, on Saturday and Sundays. So these are the sprints we had organized on Srijan.
Right. Thank you, Manjeet. So basically, one of the things which we had in our sprints unique was we had a sort of diversity, right? In most of the sprints, what we see, like, it is just the themers and the developers who are contributing back, right? So what we tried to bring in was a diversity. Rather than just having themers and developers contributing back, we encouraged our QA folks to come back and contribute, right? So contribution from a QA perspective would be, let's say Manjeet as a front-end guy, right? He goes ahead and basically fixes a D.O issue, a front-end issue, which sort of needs a manual testing, right? So someone from our company, basically a QA guy, would go ahead and basically test that particular issue in all the browser, right? The thing which we do for any client, right? Basically test it on mobile, test it on basically IE and all the stuff. And then this is how we basically try to onboard the QA as well, right? So one thing which is not possible is like organizing sprints every week is not possible and not sustainable as well, right? Because in case like you try to come to office every Saturday just for the sprint, right? Like there's hardly any time left for your personal things, right? Or probably your family and or your maybe your hobbies, right? So what we did next was sort of extended mentorship during the office hours, right? So probably, I think so, in case we see, right, you are working on a project, right, probably there might be a time within your project or in a day, right, wherein you are not feeling like you don't want to sort of like, you got bored of the project, right, not bored of the project, like you just want to do something just out of the project, right. So within those particular out of the hours thing, right, we came forward with an extended mentorship program, right, wherein like, in case, let's say I'm working with an issue, right, and I'm not able to fix it, since we guys are located in India, right? And most of the mentors are, they are basically based out of Europe or America, right? So during our daytime, they're not available, right? So what I would do, like in case I'm stuck in issue, I would basically go ahead and reach out someone in the company who I would feel is like technically capable enough to mentor me in this issue, right? So this particular thing, like extended mentorship during the office hours was really helpful, right? And finally, you have to reward the basically effort of the contributor, right? The entire organization is coming, basically devs, themers, and QAs are coming forward and basically contributing, right? You have to reward the effort, right? So initially, in case we talk about any DrupalCon or any Drupal event, right? Basically the ones which happened outside India, right? Most of the people who visited such kind of events, the ratio was really lopsided, right? The sales and the business people would be more and developers ratio would be really less, right? But I feel any such kind of event like the cons and camps, right, it is more of a developer's thing, right? So after this thing, what we decided, right, rather than having more business and the sales people visiting DrupalCon, it would be more developers and themers, basically the tech guys who would basically visit DrupalCon, right? So the ratio which we talk about right now after Drupal Camp Amsterdam, the ratio has been quite good, right? Now we have more developers rather than the business people visiting camps and cons, right? Basically, that eventually leads to they get to travel somewhere outside, right? That is sort of a new thing in case we talk, do not talk, not from a contribution perspective, like they get to see a new country, right? And apart from that, they also get to meet new people, right? Because of that reason, in case we talk about, right now in DrupalCamp, DrupalCon Mumbai, we have around 40 guys from Sirigen, right? And hardly, I think so, 4 people are from sales, and rest, 36 guys, all developers, QAs, and themers, right? So this particular ratio was pretty lopsided, right? It would be like 3:1 before, right? 3 sales and business guys, or probably 1 developer, right? In case we talk about the ratio now, it is much more different for us. Now, talking about the results, right? So what we did in past 1.5 years and what exactly happened, right? So right now we are around 150 guys within our company, right? And in case we take out the admin, HR, and the sales guys, probably the technical folks would be around 100 to 120, right? So in August 2014, right, we had 29 commit mentions and hardly 9 contributors contributing back, right? And this is our recent result. We have 276 commit mentions, 46 contributors. We have 37 developers who are out of this 46, 3 themers and 3 QAs. QAs is something like which we feel like is sort of unique for us, like because I've been following D.O issues from quite some time, and it would be a rare instance you would find someone from QA background contributing back, right? So this is something which we have achieved in past 1 year. And apart from that, since we have a small Rails team, we have a small JS team, they felt like since the Drupal guys were always contributing, right, and there were some other guys who could not contribute back technically, so what they did, like, they, since there was a sort of energy within the entire organization, there was sort of self-driven initiative by the other people, right? So recently, a guy who works with Node.js, he went ahead and published a Node module, right? And there were a couple of guys, basically the QAs. So in case we talk about Drupal Console project, right? The Drupal Console was translated in Hindi, and much of the translations were done by Srijan folks, and Drupal 8 Hindi, there was a basically Drupal 8 press release, right? And that thing, basically, Gabber reached out to multiple people, like, do you want to translate that thing to your respective language? So I volunteered back to basically translate that thing in Hindi. Apparently, like, I was sort of stuck. So there was a guy who basically works on a JS team, right? So since, like, translating any content to from English to Hindi didn't require any knowledge of Drupal, right? So he went ahead, along with another Drupal guy, to translating English press release in Hindi, right? So this is also a contribution. Similarly, couple of guys from our organization and other organization have went ahead and they have basically sort of started a new initiative to translate Drupal Console to Marathi as well, right? So because of this particular energy within our organization, right, a sort of small self-driven initiatives are being taken, right? Now challenges, right? In spite of, like, in case we see these numbers, right, though numbers might seem good, right, but still, like, we are still facing a lot of challenges, and you talk about that. So onboarding new members, new contributors is always a challenge, right? So we do have a sort of a onboarding call, right? Basically, in case a new intern or a new guy joins in, we try to onboard them. So this is still a challenge because telling them the benefit of contribution, like, some people might understand the benefit of contribution, some not. Like, this thing is still a challenge for us. Like, we have to tackle this problem. Probably someone from the audience can help us with that. Organizing code sprint, right? Code sprints organizing every weekend is not feasible. So what we did, like, we reached out to our guys, like, in case, like, weekend is not possible for you, like, what exactly would work for you, right? So most of the guys were quite familiar with, quite comfortable with having organization on a Friday night, right? So we sort of had a sort of overnight hackathon, right? So timing of the code sprint and exactly a consistency, like, when exactly and how many code sprints do we want in a month, right? That is something which we have to still figure out. Motivation and consistency. Still going back to the previous one, rather I'll show you the code. Yeah, this thing works fine. Right, so we've been basically trying really hard to get consistency from a lot of the people, right? Because for some people, the contribution is just limited to a sprint, like, but a contribution is also really important, like, you have to follow up on that particular issue or particular contribution after the sprint as well, right? Because the contribution should not be just limited to sprint. In case you try to follow it up and try to close that issue, right? So this particular consistency, we have to basically tackle and get that consistency within our organization so that, like, at least the guys who have been not contributing regularly can basically contribute more regularly. This is the one more. Leadership, yeah. Yeah, leadership is a part. So initially, I was leading this entire initiative because due to some sort of personal reason or family reason, I had to take a backseat. So a couple of folks came forward and took the leadership. But apparently, in the past 3 months, the leadership hasn't been that great. So we have to basically think of a sort of a delegation program in case someone basically leaves out for a temporary phase, like, we have to basically figure out a person to whom we can delegate, and so that this entire initiative which we have taken is keeps on running every time. Sustainability, right? So in case we talk about sustainability, why exactly we feel this thing was sustainable for us, right? Drupal 8 was coming, probably a lot of people were asking, like, are you ready to basically work on Drupal 8? So for that, like, we had two options, either train them, right, or either contribute back, right? So since, like, people have been contributing back, right, so they have a fair amount of Drupal 8, I mean. So one of the primary reason I was basically pushing people for contribution was because contribution, according to me, was just another reason to learn Drupal 8, right? Because trainings might be good, but in case you don't have something to work upon, right, you might not end doing something, right? So, but in case you have an issue wherein like your mentor is following up with you, like you, are you able to finish the issue, right? So using such kind of contribution, like we have been able to learn Drupal 8, and because of that, like we are already, in fact, like we are in the last sprint of a really big media site, and that particular site we have been able to launch in Drupal 8. And we removed expectations of and dependency from a single person. In case it had been a case like I was the only one who was contributing back, right? So it was a sort of expectations and a dependency on a single guy to contribute back from Cerigen, right? So in case like due to some reason I was not able to do so, right? Expectation basically there would be a dependency on me, right? So what I did, I delegated the entire dependency to the entire set of organization. I won't be doing this alone. Rather, why don't you come ahead and do the contributions, right? People taking initiative to contribute, right? This is the something which I liked personally really a lot, right? Because it was just last week and a guy from the Node team comes ahead and this says like, I have contributed back a module to the Node.js community, right? I felt really good. And there's another guy who comes back and says like, there is a, I don't know what it's called in Angular, right? Probably module, I would call it. There's another guy who works on the Angular team, right? He says like, there is another module which I'm building for the Angular.js, right? So this self-driven initiative is something which I personally liked a lot, right? Because the Drupal guys were contributing, the rest of the team basically, Angular guys, Node guys, right? And in fact, the QAs felt like, why can't we contribute, right? So sort of a self-driven initiative was taken in the entire organization, which sort of led to a healthy contribution culture in our organization. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for your time. So any questions? The employees, right?
Yeah,
exactly. Employees. So you have to encourage your, this is the part really.
Leadership can motivate and all that.
Yes.
Still, what is the?
One of the things which I personally use is this thing, right? In case a new intern joins in, I would rather go to Manjeet's profile. I believe internet stopped working. Yeah, yeah, please go ahead, please, yeah.
No, yeah, go ahead, I asked. You have to reply.
Yeah, so no, in that direction, I think is maybe you need to talk with your resources in terms about what they do, because it's natural, as he say, it's an environment. If you were in open source, if you don't contribute to the community, that's mean your environment will be go down, and eventually in the future, you will not have enough work to work. It's just any environment. So you just give to the community to try to grow up in the community, to try to have the same style of life. Because imagine you don't do anything for the software you use. You just use, but suddenly in the future that this company could be closed, and now maybe you lose your job, and now you need to start to do some job you hate. And it's your fault because you don't do anything before to try to sustain your environment. So there is, I think it's hard for companies to force to people to contribute, but it's the responsibility of the company to try to explain that to the resources. Like it's not only about the companies, it's about you. So if you want to sustain this, you just try to do something to guarantee your future.
Right, exactly. So one thing which I tell the new guys, on, in fact the guys who have been not contributing, I would say is, your GitHub profile or your Drupal.org profile is a relevant CV rather than your LinkedIn profile, right? I would go ahead and edit right now, and probably Rahul had shout at me, right? Even I believe he won't even say anything. I can go ahead and go to my LinkedIn profile and add like CEO of Cerigen Technology, right? But that is sort of fake thing, right? But your Drupal.org profile, right? That shows your commitment towards Drupal.org, probably in case you are contributing back to some other technology which has been hosted on GitHub, right? That is your real CV, right? I might get out of Cerigen sometime, right? That I don't see happening, at least for some years, right? But the years of experience, the experience which I've learned, right? Basically, I can give two kinds of CV to my next employer, right? That would be some sort of Word document, which I have the rights to edit, right? That is not a relevant CV for me. Rather, I can say, like, go ahead and look into my GitHub profile, or rather, look into my Drupal.org profile. Right? That is more relevant CV for me, right? You are sort of creating and enhancing your skill set. So that is important for everybody.
it's one way of doing it.
Right, exactly.
In open source, it is easy. In other technologies, it is very difficult.
Right, exactly. So in case you are working with open source, like that is something like GitHub and your Drupal.org or any other, like you're working with say MySQL or Angular, in case they have a community page, that is more important. That is rather a more important, relevant CV.
So would you say your personal branding and your personal credibility
right, exactly.
is more important right. to a person rather than any other threat or any other monetary incentive?
Right, exactly. Yes, I would say that. Anything else?
And also the second part is the how the employer can incentivize contribution or encourage contribution by saying, you know, if you make X number of contributions, you know, this is how your, you know, growth path may look like. So this is another way to encourage and, you know, show to people, you know, these are the benefits of contributing back.
So I think it's contributing is a culture that I think it's very nice that Srijan has shown that they're able to inculcate into their developers. And I think it's a benefit for the organization to encourage this in different ways. Probably you could set aside some of your work time. It need not be on a weekly basis. You could do like just a half a Saturday on once a month where you have your team on work hours, contribute to projects. And I think it's exciting for the contributors that their profile is building, but it is more important for the organization to know that they are building capability in their employees to actually reach out and have skills that is more global, certified by others in the community. So which means you start understanding best practices, you start understanding how to work as a team, which is global, far beyond the organization. There is a lot that your employees are to learn from this exercise. So I think organizations should start looking at it as a benefit to them and not just the profile of the employees, and set aside time for them to exercise and do this and encourage this kind of culture where you know, the employees are able to come and speak up on a stage on a DrupalCon about something that they actually took up as an initiative and did. These are different ways in which you can actually sustain it.
So my question is, how do you find time to do all these things when doing your projects? And to help people, we need mentors, right?
Right.
And mentors are technically capable people, which almost always they will be busy in some or other projects. Most of the services oriented company, that is the thing. We have deadlines, timelines. All these things are there.
Right.
And how to sustain to bring a sustainable effort. We have to put quality time into it.
Right, exactly.
So how do you manage that?
So to answer your question, I have what I am doing. So I find out two issues on a weekend basis. So as per the feedback, so I am working on the after the office hours. So if anybody commented, suppose.
Motivate people working outside office hours.
Even if like it's not possible, right? Contributing a small thing wouldn't take more than half an hour, right? Because like probably you might write a patch, and that particular patch would be, just taking an example of patch, right? Would be like unit tested using like the automated test which we have in Drupal.org, right? And someone from the previous mentor would basically come back and, right? So this entire process, in case we think about, right? This entire process takes a bit of time, right? But the time which an individual wants to give is hardly, I believe, not more than half an hour a day, right? So that's what I do. Because some of the contribution which I did, I think so 2.5 months back, right? That particular patch got committed just yesterday, right? So a sort of a consistency has to be maintained.
Yeah, some follow-up is required.
You cannot update an issue queue
exactly.
leave it that way.
Right. A follow-up is
you
always
have to
required.
Follow-up.
Right, exactly. So and that particular follow-up, right, hardly, yeah. You won't even need half an hour, right? you can say like, this is the wrong, this thing some went wrong, right? I will work on the next one. And it would be a case like you do not find to work on the next issue for some days. And your mentor is also knows, right? Like you are busy working somewhere else, like then he would never shout at you, right? He knows like, would like to ask something?
You can check that up on Drupal.org. So if you can encourage your team to be available during those times initially, then they get guided by a set of people who know the entire process. And once the onboarding is set and they start experiencing the benefit of being in the community, you don't need to worry about where they get the time from. They will do that automatically. So I think the initial responsibility is with the organization to help them to beat that hurdle. And some of that is also cultural for us because we are maybe sometimes very inhibited to say, what will happen if I make a mistake? So many a times being in this core sprints really helps you to break that ice and, you know, try out and experiment something with the mentors. And once that ice is broken, you probably see that they'll figure out just, I think like what Manjeet said, 2 to 3 hours a week is sufficient once you know the whole process, how it works.
Yeah. So if you are following suppose particular issue, so you don't need time to understand that issue. So any other questions?
Now, in case that it becomes a habit, right? Probably at a later stage, you all would like to do, right? Because personally, I would say like I haven't contributed back in last few months, right? Because like I had due to time constraint, and at this stage I sort of even feel guilty, like why I'm not able to contribute, like so. This particular, in case you get that sort of feeling, right? So you don't have to encourage anymore, right? Rather, it is your employees like who tend to do the contribution themselves.
Making it a habit, I like
that. Exactly, yeah. In case you don't do it, like you start feeling sad, right? I'm not able to do this. What should I do now next? Right, exactly.
And
yeah.
Want to go there.
So what I have done, like it was what happened in past, like.
It's difficult to make people get into that habit.
See, you can use the same Drupal community to say it's so difficult to build a community. But then, I think in giving recognition, giving the time, so if you feel there is a need as an organization, there is a benefit for me. Because my team members are getting exposure. My team members are delivering better quality. You should feel as organization leaders and senior professionals that you want them to participate. Let them break the ice. So one is to sit back and say it's difficult. Another is to sit with them and see how do you break the ice.
So like we have a tendency to open Quora or Facebook early in the morning. Right? What I have done is like, this is Lime Chat, which I use for my IRC communication, right? So I've added an option, right? Open it login. So every time I open my computer, right, early in the morning, right, this thing would open up, right? I have added a couple of IRC channels. I just don't just contribute back to Drupal, right? I'm trying to contribute back to Git as well. I'm trying to basically figure out to something, contribute back to Lucene, Elasticsearch. So these are the default channels in case I open my computer every time, right? I'm sort of logged into these, right? So even if I do not have time, I just go ahead and browse through the communication happening between the, let's say, some other folks in the IRC, right? That is also a learning. So a sort of a habit has to be developed. That's it, I think so.
I just want to add that if you want go to drupal.org/project/issues, there are most of the issues. So you don't need much time for that. You have to just re-roll the patch. You have to just remove the white spaces from there. You have to do a grep search, and the patch will be ready in the 5 minutes. So you don't need time for it. And you just open drupal.org, check for the latest issues, that is latest updated, and you can create a patch for that. That is also a contribution for you.
Yeah.
So is there a way to get notified, you know, when there are updates happening to the issue queue?
I'll show you that. Just one second.
Because so far, you know, the issues I've looked at or commented at, you know, unless I go back to the my dashboard page.
So there's a setting, so you can enable that, so you can get the updates from that. So every so if anybody had commented on that issue, so you will get the mails from there.
I think it's in your profile.
It's in your profile. Yes. So in case like you are not working on an issue and still you feel like this thing seems sort of interesting to you, you can go ahead and try follow right over here.
Yes.
But this particular notification won't come in case I believe there is a setting.
So there's a setting in the profile.
Okay, I did not see that option. So I was always wondering that I need to go and follow back on the issue rather than.
Yeah, this is the part, Shweta. So you have to enable right the issues which you follow, right?
Yeah.
Do you want notification for that or not? Yeah? Blah, blah, blah. This is the one. Issues you follow, right? Issues you follow, documentation, Drupal core, Drupal site, right? You can.
Okay. Yeah. I think this is very helpful because I wasn't aware of this.
Right. Exactly.
Okay.
Depending upon your comfort level, right? You might not want to follow everything. You want to follow the ones.
I think this one is all that you comment on. There's one second there.
Okay.
In case you comment, that by default it says like you are following this issue. So in case you do, use this setting like issues you follow. I think so that should work fine.
Right, yeah. You're right. Issue you follow is
exactly.
Yeah. I was also interested in contributing to the documentation, but somehow the process seemed so complicated. Like
documentation
you have to
is the easiest part. I'll show.
to you know set up and stuff like that, and there were a lot of documentation, so many pages with you know so large comments. I could never, you know, get there. So if there's some easy way to do that, you know, if you can point me to those links, that will be very helpful.
Yep, I'll show you that.
So you're here for the sprint tomorrow.
Yes.
You should.
Okay.
Very good place to start.
Yes. So in case, let's assume I'm on some page, right? This is documentation.
No, I was specifically asking for the Drupal 8 documentation or the user guide.
Yes. So there are two sets of document.
Sure. Yeah. All right. Thanks so much.
Thanks a lot. That's it. Anything else? Thanks a lot for coming. So I would say, like, try to come to the course sprint tomorrow. Probably that might, in fact, like, I believe a course sprint is also going right now as well. Try to come over there, and you would get a lot of more answers over there. And I would really love in case you could go ahead to the schedule page and try to evaluate this session. Thanks for your time, everybody. Thanks a lot.